celebrate Holy Mass in this 30th week, this 30th Sunday of Ordinary Time, we celebrate in loving memory of Mary Ann Low Sheldon, who went to eternal rest not just a few weeks ago. This morning's schedule, as you see, we got a lot going on. Our kids' Halloween party and coffee hour take place after Holy Mass today. Because of the parking situation, we're announcing now that at least for the cemetery service, we're bringing it back here to church. It'll be at 12:15. So put a sign up there. I know some people come, we're not part of the parish. At 12:15, we're going to have the cemetery service here at church. We'll see about the trunk or treat. It looks like it's going to dry up, but luckily our parking lot is not made out of grass, so that might be okay. Stay tuned for that, and of course, bowling as well. You might have heard that it sounded a little quieter during the opening hymn. Our organist Chris's voice isn't doing great. I know half of you are cheering, half of you are, aww. But that means I want you to sing louder today. Put a little oomph in it. It is not an oomph kind of day. I understand that. It is yucky, it's cloudy, it was dark when you woke up, but we can put a little more oomph into our singing today. All right, this week we have a few other things going on. Tomorrow will be a restaurant fundraiser at the Burntwood Tavern in Brecksville. Just bring in the ads, whether it's the one you see downstairs, whether it emailed out to you on Facebook, and that goes all day, from 11 a.m. when they open until 9 p.m. This week, just to make a little note on our Wednesday change of schedule from the newsletter, no Bible study, but there will be our All Saints Day Mass at 10 a.m. on November 1st, All Souls Day Mass, 9 a.m. November 2nd, and pierogi making on Saturday. Lots going on, as well as a few other announcements there. As we close out the month of October with our worship, let's quiet our hearts and minds this day as we enter into the sacred place celebrating our contemporary rite of the Mass that begins on page 63. All your sins, and using the second confiteor on the bottom of page 66, please recite with me. I confess to Almighty God, in the presence of the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have sinned through my own fault, in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done or failed to do. I ask the Blessed Virgin Mary, all the saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God. The holiday of Halloween has, of course, many, many religious implications, and it has Catholicism at its beginning, with kids dressing up like their favorite saints at the very beginning on All Hallows Eve, preparing for that great day. They simply ask that tiny bit of history and the sight of little ghouls and ghosts and all that throughout this week, let it be your call to pray. To pray not just for the children you see, whether it's today or throughout this week to the 31st, but just to keep that as a call to prayer for all children indeed. Again, let those costumes be a call for your prayer for our children. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And may our Lord Jesus Christ absolve you, and with his authority vested in me, I absolve you from all your sins, in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Therefore you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, and with all your soul, and with all your strength.
This is the commandment we have from him. Whoever loves God must also love his brother.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be.
to God in the highest.
Thank you. seen God. Yet, if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew. Pharisees heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees. They gathered together, and one of them, a scholar of the law, tested him by asking, "Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest?" He said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the greatest and the first commandment. The second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. The whole law and the prophets depend upon these two commandments." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Commandments that those in the law and those who practice law looked at and they pulled out from the Old Testament, from 613 down to 2. It's part of the point. Keeps coming back to this, combining of these two laws. And many times that Jesus teaches about love, Christ is trying to connect those challenges then and us now, hearers in the 21st century, that love of neighbor is an expression of love of God. It's expression of God's love when we love our neighbor. Get that? Hard to get, hard to grasp that. It's theological, I know. Rather than get stuck on the intricacies of what love is, I got stuck on that last statement of the gospel. The whole law and the prophets depend on these commandments. Doesn't that last little thing seem like it was tossed in there afterward? It doesn't line up with some of the other things that we've heard when it comes to his teachings on love. Prophets depend on us. The commandments depend on us. So what does this have to do with anything? We turn back the clock in St. Matthew's Gospel. If you open up your Bibles, I promise you can find it. It's Matthew chapter 7, verse 12. It's when Jesus is still teaching on the Mount after the Beatitudes, but nobody's gotten up after the Beatitudes. They still wanted more. So he teaches them for a few chapters, and he spells out the Golden Rule. You know the Golden Rule, right? You were taught the Golden Rule a long time ago. Matthew 7:12 says, "In everything, do to others as you would have them do to you." Did you know that was scripture? Or do you just think the golden rule was whatever they taught you in kindergarten or first grade? My son learns it part of the Bear Way. The golden rule is contained within it. And probably something like that, we all learn that too. Except, the golden rule is only half of that verse. It says, "For everything, do to others as you would have them do to you. For this is the law and the prophets." So the golden rule as laid out to us in Scripture is the law and the prophets. This whole way of thinking isn't uniquely Christian, though. It's offered by early Jewish rabbis. It exists in Islam, in Greek philosophy, in the works of Confucius. It is a moral and ethical good. Do good, be good, get good. We can kind of get that, right? Okay. That's sort of what the golden rule is. And while there's some confusing stuff to that, it's best explained as a reminder. When we look at the golden rule, and it's depending on law and prophets, the reminder is that Jesus is the fulfillment of everything that exists in the Old Testament. The creation of the first man, to the establishment of the Holy Land, to the great effects of repentance and obedience to the word of God given to the prophets, and everything that was spoken about a Messiah to come, from prophets to kings to judges, they all funnel towards one spot. Messiah, God coming on earth. The Old Testament, the law and the prophets, as it also is known, packs up the car, and drives us to the front door of the Gospels themselves. The Gospels that begin with the perfection of Christ, the forgiveness granted by him, the sacraments that are now available to us, the sacraments that allow us to actually follow the golden rule, the commandments of love as well. The commandments of Jesus, love God with all heart, soul, and mind, and neighbor as self, they're great, we know them, right? But we're going to fail at that. We know them, and we might know them better than any other piece of scripture, but it's also the ones that we trip over ourselves perhaps the most. If we're not getting mad at God, I'm really good at getting mad at God, we're getting mad at someone here on earth. Usually the people we love the most, because that's who we like to beat up on the most, those we spend the most time with, the very ones we make vows to and oaths to, whether it's in wedding or baptism or whatever it might be. Jesus is the avenue for that true forgiveness when that failure happens, that everything was pointing to in the Old Testament. This is how these two commandments hang on the law and on the prophets. Jesus spoke of the importance of these laws enough that versions of what he spoke on are in all four Gospels, simply that God has always wanted us to love him and our neighbor. To the divinity of Jesus, that the message became simplified. But the Old Testament is the backbone of all of this. It's what St. Paul wants from us, too. Remember what St. Paul was doing. He was the first person to come into all these new lands. Imagine that Mediterranean Sea, making those loops around and visiting these big cities that had never heard of Christ before, that had never heard of Judaism before, in some spots at least, and telling them of the Savior of the world, the God on earth, and how this God was a God of love. He understood the mindset of Jesus enough in our second reading today to the people of Thessalonica to tell them they need to become imitators of us and of the Lord. Because he's thrilled with everything that's happening in that church that he went and established, that he came back and visited. It reminds them that it is all because of Jesus that good things are happening in your church. The deep homily today. Pulling out Old Testament stuff and, oh man, I know that. But just know this. Jesus came into the world to make it better for us. That's what the law of love is. Making it better isn't just saying yes. They made movies on that. It's not just giving presents. They wrote books about that. Parents know that to raise children right and loving correct is by building up and teaching correctly. Jesus teaches us and builds us up correctly today that it's all built up to him. That his teaching, this divine teaching come down from heaven, is of God, and we are the fruits of it. That we fully appreciate the realization that's fulfilled in Scripture. Take some time to think about who and why we love today. Simple. Who and why we love today is what our Mass focuses on going forward. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Rise and together profess our faith. I believe in one God,
Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he was born of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, fulfilling the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand. Father, he will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear
truly love and serve their neighbors. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For widows, orphans, the poor, needy, and homeless, who cry out for justice, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For deep faith, St. Paul commends the churches for the example they provide in faith. May we echo the love that brings about such commendable faith. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For God's loving protection on the children and families who will walk neighborhoods this Halloween. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For God's help, strength, and assistance for brothers and sisters in need, especially Richard and Edna Samuelson, Jack Spilka, Eugene Beggin, Kim Penny, Shannon Alvarino, Donna Markowitz, Kathy Robertson, Lou and Margaret Hefner, Matthew and Sue Ann Penny, George Zeifel, Penny Dennison, Joe Orlowski, Michelle Ostrowski, Shauna Smallen, Bob Lucas, Tom Dennison, Bob Becker, Jay Jersick, Greg Holder, Phil Simmons. For all on our prayer list, for those grieving a loss due to the hatred of neighbor, for those living whom we lift up in prayer this day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the souls, for those who walk this earth as our brothers and sisters, especially our sister Mary Ann Rochelle, for all departed friends and family members of our parish, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and merciful God, grant our prayers. We strive to love you as we love one another, taught by your only Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
If anyone says, I love God, hates his brother, he is a liar. Whoever does not love a brother whom he has seen, does not love God, whom he has not seen. Sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. others to love as you love, and to forgive others as you forgive us. We ask this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
His glory.
glorious resurrection and his exaltation at your right hand. We await his coming in the fullness of majesty. We here set forth this sign of our faith in him, who offered you the perfect sacrifice and gained for us eternal salvation. Send your Holy Spirit, the giver of life and holiness, upon us and upon these gifts, the bread and wine of eternal life. Holy Spirit, come to us, fill us with your gift of grace. Take these gifts from our hands, Lord God, as an acceptable sacrifice, through which we offer ourselves to you, so that the bread which we break and the cup which we bless may be shared in the body and blood of your Son. May all who receive from your heavenly altar always remain united with you, together with all your saints and chosen ones, the blessed and glorious Virgin Mary, the Mother of our Lord, your prophets and apostles, with your martyrs and confessors, and with all who stand about your throne in praise and prayer. And also, Lord, to share in that glory to the departed, to those who remember before you, especially as we celebrate today's Mass in memory of Mary and Low Shelter. Deal with them and with all people according to your merciful kindness, and let perpetual light shine upon them. Remember also your servants on earth for whom we invoke your mercy, especially all those whom we have raised up in our intercession instead, for those who we hold in the quietness of our own hearts. Bless your church throughout the world, grant it unity and peace, renew the earth according to your promise. Remember all peoples and grant that all nations may give you thanks, worshiping and praising your holy name. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Through him, with him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Thank you.
eat the bread of heaven and call upon the name of the Lord.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you. Tell me, say the word, and I shall be healed.
And body of Christ, bring me to everlasting life. Christ, bring me to everlasting life. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the table of the Lord.
I know.
sins.
Lord, Christ so loved us, we also must love one another.
Let us pray. Lord, our God, you joined us to the company of the chosen, and have fed us with the bread of life. May we who have shared at your altar share our love with each other. In the name of Christ our Savior, we ask this through the same Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.